Okay, we are live, I think, I hope. Spontaneous stream, I'm just going to play something. I have nothing else to do today. And we're going to talk about some stuff.
Things happened. Noah was impressed by them. So.
Yes. Should we start with the Denning interview before I get into gaming and we talk about the other thing?
Sure.
Whichever way you want to.
Okay, let me find the interview.
Denning is always entertaining.
Yeah. By the way, I was going to say, I like that Matt is like the official EU expert by virtue of having read the books once.
Yeah, when they came out.
Indeed.
Oh, you mean Alex, Deathscream.
True. It is a great scream, so yeah. Quite iconic. It's more iconic than anything else.
Okay, can you hear the audio?
So, after you finish that...
Yes.
Okay.
By the way, we have watched some of this.
Okay, okay.
Because I recognize the interviewee. He has like a really solid voice, and he was... This is the interview where you first found out about Pages of Pain.
Oh, okay. Let's see.
Series, you got to write Crucible, which just came out recently, I think last summer. Yep. And, what was so I guess at that point they just wanted a single standalone story just to kind of act as a bridge or just to move the plot forward?
Well, originally Crucible was always kind of an odd duck. And in that originally they said, well, we want you to kind of write a swan song for the big three and kind of have them retire. And so I came up with an idea that, you know, which I kind of called mythic elevation because I thought, well, okay, they really want to move them off stage. And so the only way I could think of to do that, move them permanently off stage without having them be killed, because that was not in the cards and I wouldn't have done it anyway.
I don't believe that's
was
true.
To just move them to a stage where they're not going to be able to be involved with the everyday workings of the Jedi anymore. Mm-hmm. And so I wrote a story idea for that and passed it in, and they said, well, you know, that's just a little bit too weird. So I came back and I wrote a more mundane version, which just
Should
involved,
we pause when we have something to say?
You know, kind of some Mandalorians tearing them up and then kind of realizing that.
So he didn't want to kill them off. I believe in that. I believe him.
I don't.
I don't. I'm not sure.
I don't, because we know he wanted to kill Han at one point in Legacy of the Force instead of Mara.
But did he want that?
I think so. I think that was the thing.
Who else would have wanted it?
I could have. I would have wanted it.
I believe Denning would have murdered every character if he had a chance.
But the thing is, you've heard that he was planning on making them the main characters in the Han Solo trilogy.
Yes, or at least like active members of the story.
Someone wanted it. Yeah, it was a... You know, it was brought up in a room and everyone went silent. But then Lucasfilm said no, so, you know, we never got that.
But, you know, maybe it's time to pass the torch. And they're like...
Well, oh, yeah, maybe it's time.
Perhaps.
Well, you know, that's not weird enough.
One could argue it's too late, but...
So eventually we kind of arrived at the story that became Crucible. And which was good, you know, and I started writing it. I was about halfway through writing it when Disney bought Lucasfilm. And the idea when I started writing it was that it was going to be a passing the torch book. I think it was kind of the way I finally wrapped my head around looking at what they wanted was, you know, we're just passing the torch on to the next generation, to Jaina's generation, which really it's time to do, you know. Yeah. I mean, it's time for her to
True.
Be much older. Luke was when he had to step up, much older than her, you know.
And whose fault is this?
About her dad's age when he had to step up, and older than her mom was, so it's time for her generation to kind of do, you know, take the lead. Wait,
rewind, like 20 seconds.
I think it's kind of the way I finally wrapped my head around looking at what they wanted. Because, you know, we're just passing the torch on to the next generation, to Jaina's generation, which really it's time to do, you know. Yeah. I mean, it's time for her to, she's much older than Luke was when he had to step up, much older than her, you know, she's about her dad's age when he had to step up, and older than her mom was, so it's time for her generation to kind of do, you know, take the lead.
They did that in New Jedi Order.
She's about the age of her dad when he had
she's older.
29.
She's older. Han in New Hope is 29. Jaina in Crucible is 32.
32 only?
No, she's not.
Isn't she like in her 40s already?
No. No, she's like...
in her early 30s. Which Matt Wilkins doesn't understand.
Right?
Because Matt Wilkins doesn't understand how time works. Because I remember he was like, how old are they? Like mid to late 20s?
Well, he did say that she was older than her dad when he had to step up. So.
Crucible is
45. ABY.
So she would be 34.
Oh, even 36. Older than I guess.
She would be 36 then.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Yeah, wait, when's the last command? When's that?
Nine ABY
and then 45 ABY.
Yeah, 36 then.
Yeah, she's 36 years old. Well, yeah. It's time for this young generation to take the lead.
Never mind the fact that they're all dead at this point.
Jaina has left. Who else?
Ben, they could, I guess. They could almost have children who are prepared to step up.
They do. They have Alana.
Yeah, and they have Ben. He's a child.
What are we talking about?
Troy Denning, because of this terrible Crucible interview. He's like, it's finally time to pass the torch to the young generation with Crucible. Even though New Jedi Order already did that, and Jaina, he just talks about her age. It's time because she's getting older. She's 36 in Crucible. She's literally older than Han was in A New Hope.
Oh, and Noah, since you've read the book, how does it work if you look at it on its own? How does it work as a passing the torch story?
Not really.
Yeah, that's the question.
Han and Leia just going on this. Han, Luke, and Leia are going on this adventure, and it seems just like boring, kind of like standard stuff. And then it turns into an LSD trip where Troy rips off the crystal star. And then they just say, fuck it. And then they just say, like, oh, you guys deal with it. And then they leave. And that's it.
Is there any like scene of them feeling that they're too old for this?
Yes, in the epilogue, literally like the last two pages, Luke is like, they are all sitting in a cantina, and Luke is like, I'm so fucking old. And then he looks around and he sees Jaina, Jack, Ben, Tahiri, and everyone's favorite character, Omad Kay, who's just like Han Solo. And he's like, the galaxy is in good hands. Even though the previous series, Darkness, Legacy of the Force, and Fate of the Jedi, were all about how the Jedi Order is dysfunctional and terrible and doesn't work without Luke Skywalker. And now he's like, well, I'm gonna leave. I know you are currently at war with the Lost Tribe of the Sith and the entire galaxy and the government hates you, but I'm gonna go full Yoda.
Can it be argued that the Jedi, after all of this, are in a worse place than they were after the prequels? Like,
kind of.
I mean, there still is like Jedi.
There still is Jedi, but they are at war with a Sith faction. They know about a secret other faction. They are haunted by a Force God demon. The government hates them, and the only person financing them, I guess, is Lando at this point. So yeah, they are fucked.
And as we will see later, they do get fucked by the Sith.
Mm-hmm. The one Sith, because apparently they were so incompetent, even though they have camera recordings of what Darth Krayt looks like, they never find out about the one Sith.
Oh dear. Yeah. I'm not looking forward to finishing the ending verse.
Lost Tribe of the Sith.
What was that question?
Would you say The Lost Tribe of the Sith is the best Fate of the Jedi book that isn't Backlash? Yes.
No, I wouldn't.
I would.
I think Outcast is better. I think Omen is better. Yeah, that's about it.
Shall we continue? Because I want to get to the fun part, which is the game. And we have to hurry up because we are watching a movie at 1800.
True.
And so that's kind of...
Oh, Alex, you're going to be here for it. We're going to watch The Thing, finally, John Carpenter's best
great
movie.
Film.
Yeah. I bought the DVD for it, just so we can watch it, because I only had it on Blu-ray.
What I wrapped my head around the purpose of the Crucible was going to be, and I had wrote the story and had this nice scene that the epilogue was originally going to take place back on Shady Lot,
at
the Jedi base, where you know there's going to be the symbolic passing of the torch kind of scene. But then Disney bought Lucasfilm, and you know we realized, well, the EU's future is just totally...
Wait, so the original ending was on the Jedi Academy on Shadumat, the passing of the torch moment. And then just after Disney bought it and he learned it was the end, he set it in a filthy bar. So
are
I
they
don't...
on Tatooine?
No, they are on the place near the whatever it's called, where the Not Mortis monolith is.
I guess it's kind of supposed to be like a family moment. They're on a restaurant together.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sure he does. What he describes, what he wants to do, that's... He was... The Denningverse was the Disney sequels before the Disney sequels.
Totally up in that, up in the air, and we have no idea what we're going to be passing the torch on. Obviously, there's going to be a transition, but we don't know what that transition will be. So kind of midstream, you know, the focus of the book shifted to just becoming both the kind of sealed Han and Leia and Luke's legacy, if you will, in the galaxy. And hopefully, you know, without closing off the future, because obviously we don't know, we didn't know then, even when the next, you know, when the next episode 7, 8, and 9 were supposed to start. Of course, we just found out last week that it was 30 years later.
Yep.
Approximately the right timeline, but... So that was
could you imagine another
kind movie? Of an interesting project because of the whole.
What did you say?
Could you imagine another 9-book series after Crucible?
No, they said they said they were moving away from that concept. Thank God.
Yeah, they said a lot. I think
whole transition, you know, in terms of what happened with Lucasfilm, Disney, and whole future of the EU. And, you know, the book was always going to be. A transition book, you know, kind of a passing the torch book, but it went from passing the torch to something that it was very firmly planted in my mind, you know, and the plans that Del Rey had for where the EU was going next were just fantastic, you know, and that was one of the seeds we tried to lay with Apocalypse was, you know, we just tried to open up all kinds of different story possibilities at the end of Apocalypse so that you could have just a million different kinds of stories for the Jedi and the rest of the galaxy.
Yeah. Now, welcome, Liv.
Hey.
So, yeah.
I mean, I guess there was possibilities. There were possibilities.
Okay. Yeah.
I guess there were.
Hmm. What were they? Just more Sith.
The monolith dagger.
Hmm.
More Sith, Jaina forming the Imperial Knights.
That wasn't really a... No, that's not hinted at the end of Apocalypse, because Jack Fell leaves the
Empire. Well, there's resolving the election thing. Who even won the election?
Pelion's bastard child.
Oh, that's right.
Vito.
Well, they have to resolve that.
Yeah.
Who's that? Do I have to know that person?
No, yeah. He's just a side character in some earlier books like NJO and Legacy of the Force. Vito Rage. Yeah.
Do we know the mother?
What?
Do we know the mother?
No. Some woman Pelion fucked a bunch of bitches. That's his thing. But
imagine.
Oh, we also didn't learn what happened to Darla. She just disappears at the end of the book, and she's the secondary main villain.
Yeah, imagine.
And obviously, there's Vestara. There's the ship. So there's a lot of stuff.
Imagine they would have just said it is Pelion's and Darla's child. I would have
No, stop it. No.
They had something in Dark
Souls. No, no, stop it. No.
I remember when being excited for Fate of the Jedi, because Noah kept saying, you kept saying it was really good and it was much better than Legacy of the Force back in the day.
Compared to Legacy of the Force, yes. And then I reread Apocalypse.
Yeah, but that's, I remember that and remember being really excited for it. And now I'm just dreading. I'm going to do it at some point, but I'm kind of putting it off.
Yeah, the lead up to Legacy makes even less sense.
I remember the times when Noah used to consider Invincible his least favorite EU book. That was a time that existed.
Ah, yes.
Innocent times.
And that's what we've been intending to pass the torch to. And of course, now we knew nothing about what we were passing the torch to. So it became interesting. And the biggest change, really, that in the end, you know, I spent probably a month just agonizing over what I should do. You know, should I try to, you know, introduce some time element or some really cool mystic element where we could transition whatever they did.
Yeah.
Did he just say he was thinking about inserting time travel?
No, just a time element.
That sounds to me like he was thinking about something very stupid.
Yeah, it could be flow walking. It could be visions of the future, dimensions. Visions of the past.
The time element, really.
I don't think he was planning on doing time travel, just like...
or opening the possibility of different dimensions. And because he's talking about the passing of the torch already. And the Disney sequels coming.
Yeah, no, different dimensions already exist. Like, that's not... That's
I know, not. That's why he maybe would have done it.
And that's also kind of what happens in Crucible. It's at least one other dimension.
Yeah,
we have the Waru dimension and we have the dimension from Planet of Twilight already. I guess we have the Crucible dimension, so there you go.
You know, in movies, and I realized that, well, it became apparent very quickly that I wasn't going to ever be told anything about what they were going to do in the movie.
Yeah.
So it would be strictly a guessing game. And then...
You just did the best you could with the information you had?
Just did the best I could with the information we had. And in the end, you know, I was talking it over with Shelley, and she basically said, you know what, we're just writing a book about the EU as it is. Just write the best book you can about the EU, and don't worry about what's happening with the future of the EU, because you just can't know. You know, nobody knows. Probably at that point, the screenwriters probably didn't even know. So we did that, but the one change I did make was that I moved the epilogue from Shadu Mod back to the Red Ronto, just so that I could place the emphasis more on Luke and Han and Leia than on the next generation of Jedi.
Now, one thing...
Wait, so that it would focus more on Han and Leia than the next generation of Jedi, is that what he said?
Yeah, because if it's on Shadu Mod, you'll see all the younglings and stuff.
Oh, if you will see bar, new characters!
Well, you have the new characters in the bar.
We have Omad, who's just like Han Solo, everybody's favorite character introduced in that book.
I mean, the new characters, that's for the next trilogy. This is a passing of the torch moment, so he wants to focus on the big three retiring.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Readers will certainly notice in Crucibles that Han, Luke, and Leia take quite a beating. Did you have a lot of injuries?
Okay, Noah, this is the part we've already seen.
Yes, I remember.
Well, not as many as my younger brother.
Yeah.
But yeah, I've had a few. I mean, I played football all through high school and through college. I played Division III football for 4 years in college. And then I was raced on our high school ski team and was an all-state ski jumper. So I've had my fair share of injuries. I mean, you know, half a dozen concussions and knee injuries and dislocated or broke every finger on my hands, you know. So I've had a little bit of experience.
So have you drawn a lot of that into your stories then when you do injuries to your characters?
The injuries that I've really had have always been things that I consider relatively minor compared to some of the things that happened to the characters in my books. But it does give you an experience, something to draw on in terms of realizing, you know, okay, when you get injured, how do you physically feel? You know, I've had enough of that experience to
would you agree be with able that, to Mark?
Extrapolate
an experience.
And describe it.
Now, on that same subject, pain is a very common theme in a lot of your books, both Star Wars and non-Star Wars. the heroes in your novels often have to go through a lot of pain as they transition through the story. Is there a reason why that is such a strong thematic influence in your stories?
I am a guy who wrote a book called Pages of Pain. So. Yeah, you know, I think that the real reason that there's a lot of pain in my book is because, you know, pain is a teacher. And, you know,
I would like to point out, Liv may remember from reading the Bane trilogy, that's literally the Sith teachings. And that's how Troy Denning writes the Jedi Order.
And
by the way, this is a pretty sane take, if you'll just let him explain.
Mm-hmm.
In every level, if you think about it, when you're growing up and you burn your fingers on a burner or something, I mean, it teaches you that fire is dangerous. And when you make a mistake and give your heart to the wrong person, that, you know, that teaches you to be a little more cautious and reflective about who you date or choose to fall in love with. And to that extent, I've always kind of regarded pain as really the crucible that people go through before they become old and wise.
When you look at all the elements in Crucible and some of the things that happen, it's a pretty wild book. Were there any ideas that you came up with that were deemed a little too much and didn't make it into the book?
Certainly there was quite a bit of freedom given to me with this story, but there was a couple of places where maybe I did go too far. And as a matter of fact, definitely one place where I definitely got come back, and it was, remember the Sabacc game, the body steak Sabacc game.
Mm-hmm.
Originally, that wasn't simulated.
Jesus Christ, Troy.
I started that.
That would have been horrible.
I got to that chapter, and Shelley's comment started off with, like, yuck.
Okay, for those who haven't read it, there's a scene where Han and some others play strip poker, but the one who the person who loses gets, like, tortured, but only, like, simulated. Like, they say, we're going to rip one of your fingernails off. But they don't really do it. It's just simulated. And Troy Denning just said, oh, no, that was real in my first draft. And then the people at Lucasfilm told me, that's extreme, dude. Calm down. Han Solo still loses an eye in this book during an explosion. And Leia, half her face and all her hair gets burned down.
Wait, so what was it? Like strip poker or torture poker?
Torture poker.
Oh my
they also God. Put needles in Han Solo's brain.
So it's really weird. Troy Denning just have like a pain kink or what?
Yes.
He's legitimately sick. You will notice this once you start reading his books.
Yeah, and also keep watching. Play the last 1 minute. It's gonna get worse.
Okay.
Oh dear.
And after reading the rest of the comment, I didn't even try to argue the case for keeping the original more gruesome version, which, you know, and actually to tell the truth, her reaction kind of took me by surprise, because my wife is always my first reader. She's very, very good at reading things, and she works over my manuscripts before I ever, you know, show them to anybody else. And when she read it, she thought, oh man, this is cool. She really liked the original body sticks.
So his wife shares his kink.
Yes. They've created the theory that Denning's wife is the true villain.
That he's just helpless and he just does whatever his wife does.
Yeah. Because she also gets a kick out of graphic, horrible violence in a story where that really doesn't belong.
That comment is great, by the way. The last one. Who knows? Might be.
Okay, a couple of seconds left.
It's like, oh man, this is just too far.
It gets better.
I'm too far here. I was a little bit surprised. Of course, I have to think back and remember, okay, well, you know, my wife is a big Walking Dead fan. So.
Yeah, that was actually one of my favorite scenes in the book. I laughed out loud when Han's like, I bet death.
Uh-huh.
I just completely surprised that Mandalorian.
Yeah.
So many of these interviewers just aren't.
Yeah,
I don't know.
That was a fun scene.
He sounds like the Clonius.
That's just what saying. I was thinking. He sounds like an incel.
Yeah.
Because, Jesus. I mean, I have never heard Troy Denning really. I think maybe that Plumber with the Leaky Pipes interview, he sounded like he had energy there. But every other interview, he usually just sounds dead inside. So maybe.
Yes, and he sounds
like a parody of Troy Denning most of the time, I feel like.
You're right, and my original version was a bit more gruesome than what we finally went with, which is probably appropriate.
It worked out well in the end, though.
Yeah, thanks. I can get carried away once in a while. It's a good thing I have great editors.
And a wife.
It did, in fact, not work out well in the end because we still got Crucible.
Yep.
Oh, well.
I'm sad that they left out the next clip, which is Troy Denning describing the infamous scene in Pages of Pain.
Oh, yeah, when a woman of normal size gives birth to a giant.
What?
That's a scene. Troy Denning wrote a book called Pages of Pain, and that's a scene in it.
Joy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. He's happy to talk and laugh about it.
That's the guy
who got control over the Star Wars books, by the way.
What's the super disgusting horror book you recently recommended in your video with this alien monster just going around and killing a bunch of people and raping them?
Oh. I don't know what you're talking about.
Right, I'm gonna find out.
Sounds like a Stephen King book.
I don't think it was one, actually. But I'm sure Denning would be excited to write a sequel for that.
Oh wait, do you mean the novel Big Head or what?
Big Head, yeah, yeah, exactly.
Okay, that. Yeah, sure.
Big Head. Oh yeah, of course, Farley knows.
Yeah, of course he remembers.
He listened to, I think, the Audible, like the little scene that they read in the beginning, and it starts insane already. Yeah, I know Farley thinks. Well, there you go.
Do we have anything to say about the interview?
I mean, it's just typical Troy Denning, kind of.
Noah has read the book, so he's the only one who can really say anything more. What would you say, Noah? Do you have a summarizing thoughts about the interview?
No, Troy Denning is a retard, but we already knew that.
That is very true.
Yeah.
Well,
okay, I'm excited for the next one, which is gonna explore his ideas for making Alana Solo the chosen one and shitting all over Anakin Skywalker again, which he set up in Apocalypse already.
Well, that's great.
Okay, now let me start Lego Star Wars because I want to play something fun, and then we can talk about Matt Wilkins' crackhead ideas.
Do you consider this idea his most crackhead one, or do you have something else you...
I think that maybe, continuity-wise, that's his most crackhead idea ever.
Heavy Alex. Yeah, Alex is breathing very heavily. What?
Am I breathing very heavily?
And it also sounds like you have your mic halfway into your mouth.
Unfortunately not.
Yeah, kind of. Ah, Jesus. Is the game working, Noah? Oh, there you go.
Yeah. Wait, is the screen sharing working? Okay. Oh.
It's still loading, but...
You probably should be careful about the audio, because I think the game has actual movie music.
Yeah.
So...
No, it's fine in video games. That's what I've been told.
But it is the actual movie music, but it might be all right.
Yeah, I'm not
sure. It's all right in video games, that's what I've been... No, it played during the Battlefront thing, and that still worked.
Has your first strike expired?
Yeah.
Well, then it's fine.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, can you see it?
Yes.
Okay, load game, I haven't played this in forever. Let's see if I can even remember the controls.
I mean, it's the most simple controls you could think of, so...
3%. Why not just a new game?
Let's see how many hours you played for those 3%. Go to, like, the...
I played, like, I don't know, 90 minutes?
I think
yeah.
It is right there, if you go a bit more to the left.
Left where?
Oh yeah, the cantina.
Yeah,
oh, I see you completed the third level at least.
That's good.
I just recently fucking played this. This game gave me the virus, by the way.
You mean the virus?
Yeah, when I had the virus back in the day, I think that was...
Oh, you're on the pod racing level.
I could never get that. I could never get that when I was a kid. Like, I remember trying that so many times and it just being impossible. And like getting friends to come over and try who also keep failing.
Oh, yeah. As a kid,
but as not a kid, it was pretty easy, I have to say. But as a kid, I don't know. As a dumb child, like, it's impossible.
As a little kid, I played the original trilogy, the LEGO Star Wars game, and I was too... I didn't manage to kill the Rancor. I was too dumb for it. I didn't understand how it worked.
It's unbelievable.
Like, I'm like, it's so fucking
easy. But this game is just so pure. I don't know. It's just...
Yeah. I mean...
I think this game is just childhood. Just
I miss the times
childhood.
When the characters didn't talk.
Yeah.
That was great.
Yeah, just the...
The noises.
The dumb noises, yeah. This is so cute. Yeah.
I like how Anakin is as tall as Qui-Gon.
And the story is very quickly told.
Indeed.
Oh my god, here we go. Oh my god. I don't remember the controls.
It's just left and right.
Okay.
And try to drive over the
fucking...
Don't get hit by anything and...
Drive over the boost things.
Shut up, I remember this.
You just said you didn't, so...
I remember this, I'm nice. Just nervous about the controls. Fuck.
Y'all are playing LEGO Star Wars, it's adorable. No, Noah.
LEGO Star Wars is great.
Damn it, I missed the mini kit. Yeah.
The new one wasn't as fun, though.
That looked fucking so boring.
The new one was such a big disappointment.
Give me a boost!
Yeah, I was really excited for it, but it just didn't have this kind of feeling to it.
The
maybe
worst thing
I just
about
wasn't
it
a
is
child,
the level.
I guess.
No, it's legit not good. Like, the level system is really disappointing.
For me, it was also that everything was so easy, and I was wondering that was probably just because, as a kid, I would have probably loved it as well.
No, it's actually easier than the complete saga. The character, like, the enemies won't hit you.
Yeah, it's stupid.
Mm.
And the levels are just boss fights, it feels like.
Yeah, I think I genuinely heard, like, I remember seeing a bunch of levels, and I think they just made stupid decisions with like, what to even make a level. Like, they just had very random ideas, and it did not work.
I mean, if they were lazy, which I am, I would just have made it this game's level choices, and just made
exactly.
it...
Nobody wants
it and made
just
it
this
open
game,
world.
But with open world.
Yeah. Maybe included some levels everyone wants, like the Mace Windu Palpatine fight, which isn't even in the Skywalker saga.
Shit!
I'm not sure it is. I don't know.
I know for a fact it's not.
Yeah, and they could have just copied those levels, like add, I don't know, two or three more for every episode or something. And then I guess
there he is, Sebulba.
I guess they have episode 7 as a LEGO game already, and then just add the last two episodes. Like, I wouldn't even have minded to play the sequel thing, but...
And I mean, the episode 7 game is great, because it's actually... Like, the levels are long, you have different abilities, there's a lot of puzzles in it.
I mean, that's sort of cool. Yeah, Alex, it's great, but it's just heartwarming to see you guys playing it for some reason. Yeah? Oh.
Because we hate
Power
Wars.
I'm ahead. I just.
Okay. Joking for the sand people. At least the boulders have stopped this time.
Oh fuck, the boulder!
Oh, by the way, no. If you don't win this lap, you have to restart.
No? Yeah. You're kidding.
That's actually.
No, I missed.
It's fine.
If you want to see an example of...
This is better than the ones where you have to drag a bomb around, like on Geonosis or off.
Yeah, those ones are pain.
Oh yeah, I remember them.
And I won!
Yes. They actually
if you want to see an example of how bad the new game is, check out the Geonosis Arena level in the new one, and then check out the same level in LEGO Star Wars 3.
Hmm. Yeah, you also need to... Look, the Luke and Leia Endor level. Like, for one guy I watched it play, like, it actually just bugged and he just flew on forever and the next part of the level didn't load. And that was very disappointing because it was so fucking long, but just boringly long. Yeah.
Does that say Waru Jedi?
No,
yeah, Vara. Indeed, that's what it says. I remember as a kid playing through the game, reaching 100%, having all the money and nothing left to spend it on.
Yeah.
Well, 7 hours of time is good.
Fun fact, today 180,000 wouldn't be enough to get True Jedi on one level.
Awesome. Okay, continue story.
Yeah. Complete Saga I only played on DS, but even there it was really great. Like, it had so much fucking content, it's actually kind of ridiculous.
I played it on the Wii.
Oh, that's so nice.
Here's actually a level that was added for the Skywalker Saga.
Oh.
Although it's bad. Yeah, you can't play the Gungan shit on this game, but you can on Skywalker Saga.
Oh well.
Yeah.
I have to say the Lego TCW game that actually had really fun. Like,
that's the best TCW content ever made. Was that Lego game?
Yes,
because it had like Starkiller in it.
Yes, and it did. And the battlefield mode is where you have to get bases and shit and build up stuff. That was actually kind of fun.
Yeah, that was fun the first two times.
But as a child, it's the most, like, for me, it was the most satisfying gameplay loop.
If you found the secret cheat code, you can unlock the ultimate character, Savage Opress. Because season 3 was about to come out, and he was like the ultimate marketing strategy for it.
I have his collectible card from what was it, Panini, where he has like 100 strength and 100 defense. He was the strongest card in the deck because, yeah, probably the same reason.
Watching Noah play this is really unsatisfying because he lets all the studs go away.
Yeah.
Oh.
Please get the blue one. Please don't lose it. Please, yeah. Don't worry. Oh, there you go. You even managed to perfectly block them.
Are you gonna rush through the level?
No, I'm going to collect as much money as I can.
Well, you missed some at the start point.
Shut up. I missed the magnetic thing where it just flies to you immediately.
Oh, yeah, well, you can get that later. But you have
I know I can buy it later, but then I have already played the level.
Well, then you play it again.
That's
the whole concept of the game.
Yes, I know.
Do you not complete games in like the pre-played mode anymore?
No,
there wasn't light.
Oh, and he can't collect these lights.
Yep.
What? I can't.
No, you have to be a Jedi. Well, please collect the blue stud.
Where's the blue stud?
I think it's by the pillar you just walked past. Or maybe it was just a flower and it looked like a blue
stud. Yeah, flower. Ah, there we go.
So Noah, you wanted to talk about math, but what is there to say?
How stupid his timeline is?
I mean, do you have any new information there?
I guess not.
So I I open the Shadow Academy PDF. I'm going to see if it, if the word empire is mentioned and in what context.
Yeah, because people started to explain in his comments that, you know, the, what was it, the second imperium, or like the whatever imperium, that it's like a different thing. Like, why is he so insistent on that stupid Young River Knights Empire idea? I guess
so. Here's a chapter where the guy called Quarrel or whatever talks about the return of the Empire, implying that it doesn't exist anymore.
Mm-hmm. And like in the New Rebellion, they already speak about the Empire not existing anymore, really. It's just kind of gone. And nobody cares anymore. Well,
they do that in Corellian Trilogy.
Yeah. I guess, though, they would still be in the deep core, right? Because nobody was there yet. But...
So in this version, like, the Imperials do reference their Imperium as the Empire sometimes. But it might just be delusion.
It could be.
But they are thinking like we are like true empire because the other ones made peace.
Perhaps. That could be. So, Sylvat, you're saying that Matt missed a detail?
No, I'm trying to see if he did or if he's actually right and we are the idiots all along.
Oh, he's no.
So, they do some breakers call it the Second Imperium.
Mm-hmm.
But the others seem to call it the Empire. Like the fake Emperor guy, he calls it Empire.
Yeah, because I mean, I guess that would make sense because he probably believes, yeah, they are the true ones. So he would just do that.
But the good guys don't seem to call it Empire. It's just the Empire itself.
Yeah. Core probably meant the Palpatine era Empire. He was a part of, given how he crashed on Yavin 4 and wants to see the same Empire be restored.
Yeah, that's legit what he says. So that would be correct.
Yes, but it's Matt Wilkins, so he doesn't catch that and he's just thinking Empire. And Matt also doesn't know the timeline at all, or the age of the kids, or he doesn't care about like the essential chronology, the new essential chronology, the essential Reader's Companion, and a bunch of other official material saying this takes place when it does. He just doesn't care. Thank for Junior Jedi Knights.
First of all, I do have to say it's kind of painful to see you not take all the lights with you.
But
well, you said you wanted to collect everything.
Not everything, just stuff.
I just want to point out there's a guy talking about the molten planet. Oh god. NKLLON. I'm not even going to try to pronounce that. And then he talks about Alderaan.
Eklon.
Sure. And then he talks about Alderaan, which was, I quote, destroyed by the Empire's first Death Star more than 20 years before. Which would place this story at least 21 ABY.
Mm-hmm.
Story is 23 ABY officially.
Yeah, so if Matt wants to move it, he's going to have to push Hand of Thrawn back. He can't push this to before... to like 19 ABY or wherever. Did he say, does he want to move this or move Hand of Thrawn?
He wants to move this before Hand of Thrawn because he thinks there's 1 year between them.
Okay,
anyway,
well...
So he doesn't care if the kid's age doesn't match anymore.
But also they say that it's at least 21 ABY.
At least. It's 23 mm-hmm. officially, but again, Matt doesn't care. I doubt he knows what ABY and BBY stands for, by the way. That's what he's convinced me of at this point, because that is the dumbest thing he's ever come up with.
I mean, Scott Johnson also said, like, the ages wouldn't function anymore, but it would work in spirit. still father. And I think it's a given that the second Imperium would see themselves as the true empire, like every other warlord viewed themselves. Yeah,
basically. Yeah, like, remember the Crystal Star?
I do. Yeah.
I don't.
We have, okay, let me think of the factions. We have the Imperial Remnant, the Dark Empire, the Crimson Empire, the Empire Reborn, the Restored Empire, the Second Imperium.
We have a bunch of warlords.
Yeah.
Also, aren't the children literal toddlers in Hand of Thrawn? They are 7 now. So Jason and Jenny, I think, are 7 now in New Rebellion.
In Hand of Thrawn, they're 10.
Yeah, makes
but
sense.
They're young enough to be babysat by Chewie on Keshik.
Yeah, I mean, that makes sense. They're still, like, young.
I mean, my problem was that Luke's arc in Hand of Thrawn doesn't really make sense if it's after YJK, because his whole thing is that he feels like he's failed as a teacher, which only makes sense if his only current students are his
Matt
first 12.
Matt doesn't care. That's the point. He doesn't
well,
care.
Well, the point isn't to convince Matt. The point is to convince your legions of viewers watching right now.
There's nothing to convince. Matt Wilkins is dead wrong, and that's it.
Well, you have to make arguments.
His, yeah, exactly.
Same with his retarded fucking Junior Jedi Knights nonsense.
Oh, yeah. What was that about?
He thinks Junior Jedi Knights takes place during Young Jedi Knights Book 3, which doesn't make any sense.
Why would he think that?
Like something Anakin hasn't been to the academy yet or whatever. He doesn't understand there's a different class system. He doesn't understand the authors have confirmed where it's set. He doesn't care that continuity has established. Junior Jedi Knights is all before Young Jedi Knights. He doesn't care that Anakin is on Coruscant in fucking Book 3.
So the thing is,
even though by his logic, yeah. Continue.
In Book 3, Anakin says, I can't wait to go to the academy. Which, in Matt's mind, implies that he's never been to the academy before. And which would mean that Junior Jedi Knights would be after, at least after Book 3 of Young Jedi Knights.
I mean, you could at least say that's weirdly worded a bit.
It's because Junior Jedi Knights was supposed, I think it was supposed to be after Young Jedi Knights, or at least it hadn't come out at that point. So it mm-hmm. might be that Kevin thought he had never gone there.
Yeah. Which is weird because his wife wrote the second half of Junior Knights. You know?
Although in like colloquial speaking, let's say I'm going to go to vacation to the US, I could sometimes say, I can't wait to go to the US. That's not the same as me saying, I can't wait to go there for the first time ever.
Yeah,
that's
but
true, actually, yeah.
But again,
or if I say I can't wait to go to school, I'm not.
I've never been in a school in my life.
Yeah, no, that's fair.
But I mean, I get that you could interpret it that way. It's just there's other stuff telling you that it's wrong.
Oh, Father
like mentioned. Continuity.
Yeah, Father Pentastar alignment, Greater Maldrood, Eriadu authority. I guess just a bunch of other Imperial things.
Yeah, well, Pico, he did fail as a teacher, but he didn't fail the YJK class, at least not at this point.
I mean, he is responsible for a child losing an arm.
Yeah, but she's better off without it. She learned a lesson.
Because Payne is a teacher, so.
As we know from Troy Denning.
I mean, I guess the thing he said with, you know, when you touch a hot stove, you learn. Not touching a hot
you learned the fire is hot. Yeah,
yeah, I guess
that is actually a thing.
Yeah, that is true. Like, I touched a hot stove once, and then I never did again.
I once put my foot on a hot stove, and that's why I learned it.
Why?
I don't remember. I was like 5, and I burned my foot very badly.
Nice.
Noah, you know the TIE fighter on Yavin 4 in the first Young Jedi Knights book?
Yeah, what?
When was that supposed to have crashed?
TIE fighter with Qual?
Yeah, was that during the first like trench run?
Yeah, during New Hope, definitely, because he's supposed to be the pilot from the day after the Death Star.
Oh, okay.
That means that thing just was there during all of Jedi Prince.
He was there during all the stuff on Yavin.
Nice. Oh, yeah, during Dala bombarding Yavin, I guess.
Exactly. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Battle of Yavin. Yeah, Fabe, the problem is there's too many Battle of Yavins at this point. But I guess you mean...
Yeah, but we talk about the battle.
Yeah, the one battle that's not shit.
Yeah, so in Heirs to the Force...
Stop! Fuck.
In Heirs to the Force, they say that that battle was over 20 years ago, once again.
Hmm.
They say that at least 5 times, so it's hard to miss. Oh, this is interesting. This place has been abandoned for quite some time, but people have been at the Jedi Academy for 11 years now.
Oh!
Yeah.
So that's your timeline!
Since Dark Apprentice, right? When is Dark Apprentice again?
I think it's 11.
I'll look it up.
Is it 11 ABY or 12 ABY?
Not. Why does it show me the fake Starkiller? I want the book. 11 ABY, yeah.
So this would be at the earliest 22 ABY. It might be 23, but it's not been like.
It is 23 officially, but yeah, okay, 11. Okay, fair. There you go. Matt Wilkins, you're fucked. You're fucked in the head. Everything you said is bullshit. You are misinforming Expanded Universe fans and newcomers. you're a menace to defend them.
You're spreading dangerous misinformation.
He does.
At a time where misinformation is...
But you know what? Let's just all blame Zahn. This is just Timothy Zahn's fault for not reading any of the books.
Obviously, it's all his fault in the end.
I like that that's Matt Wilkins' default position. It's Zahn's fault. He doesn't care about continuity. He doesn't read other people's stuff. That's the reason.
It just has to be, yeah.
I mean, he does indeed not care about continuity.
Yeah, but sometimes it's not his fault.
Perhaps that's not as bad. Like when I started to learn what actually is part of the continuity, I was like, yeah, perhaps you shouldn't care about continuity just for the sake of it. Maybe it's just not worth it. Clearly it sounds for that Matt can't read. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Poisoned him with his terrible writing in Hand of Thrawn and Survivor's Quest.
Sure.
Jade Light, how much do you have left of New Rebellion?
Quite a bit. Wait, I have read until I'm at page 167 now, and the book has quite a lot of pages. Wait. Yeah, the last page is 527. So, I have a good chunk left, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And then afterwards, we have a little break with the Brian Daly trilogy. That's going to be the next one afterwards. And then we finally get to Corellia.
That's going to be fun.
I've heard good stuff. Did you like Corellian trilogy, sir?
No.
All of them, or just some of them?
I mean, they're fine, but it's too action-focused, in my opinion.
Oh, well, I mean...
And I don't really care for the new characters, except for Thraken.
Mm-hmm.
And the main... Oh, Noah, what happened?
I don't know! What the fuck was that explosion? I blew start. Oh.
You may have landed somewhere you weren't supposed to land, and perhaps the thing just thought you were dead now.
Yeah, there are a few nice character interactions in Corellian Trilogy. I guess the solo children are cool.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm, Lando is not cool in that book.
Lando is very cool. He's searching for a wife in that trilogy.
Yeah, he's searching for a sugar mama. That's cool. Mm-hmm. But he's also like really mean to 3PO in the entire book.
Deserved after Blackfleet Crisis, that's deserved.
I guess.
Well, I mean, he was sort of subplot
where
I mean, Lando was responsible for getting 3PO almost destroyed. So,
oh no! I remember the subplot about Mara Jade.
Oh wait, I have to find a thing for Anakin.
No, there it is.
Okay.
No, if you jump up to the box and wait for Obi-Wan to jump.
Oh yeah,
up
I know. Okay, I
one.
Remember now. I remember now. Okay.
So there's this subplot. Oh, spoiler for Kylo Ren trilogy. There's a bad guy, and we are meant to believe that the bad guy is Mara Jade because she was once with the Empire.
Really?
I wasn't interested in that subplot because she clearly isn't the bad guy.
Yeah, that sounds a bit stupid.
It's small though.
I'm sure. I see.
Okay, let's have Padme do something finally.
Remember when she was badass?
Not really.
Who? Padme or Mara?
Padme.
Yeah, for a bit.
People say that TCW made her cool.
I'm not sure I liked
people also say TCW made Anakin cool.
He is pretty cool in that. I would agree.
I mean, I guess him beating up Rush Clovis, that was kind of funny. And him dying, that was also kind of funny.
He chokes a lot of people in that show.
Yeah.
Remember when they played the Vader theme?
I do.
Yeah, that's every time he does something remotely evil.
I remember when he saw Revenge of the Sith by the sun. And he just did everything anyway. That was
wasn't it so epic when he became Darth Vader for a moment there? When he fell to the dark side?
Yeah, I remember those trailer moments.
I remember Ahsoka turning to the dark side briefly.
That was cool.
A thing. Yeah.
Because we got to see dark side Ahsoka without all the bad writing making her evil for no reason at all.
Are you talking about the Mortis arc?
Yes. Yeah, the terrible arc.
That was a thing. I remember that thing.
The worst part about that arc is that it's resolved by a Deus Ex Machina.
Well.
Because it's like the son wants to kill the father throughout all those episodes. And then in the end, the father kills himself and says, well, your power was tied to mine, so now your powers are gone.
I thought the twist was, I'm going to kill myself so you can't kill me.
That would have been a better twist. But then the son gets sad because he's like, what did you do? Now you removed my powers. And yeah, you think that he would, if he knows that, why did he want to kill him in the first place?
I mean,
Great writing, Dave.
I mean, Anakin using the force on the son and the daughter and the whole like universe spinning around him or something, that was kind of cool imagery, I guess.
I don't even think it was.
No.
So they do what they kept doing with. So they do what they kept doing with Han with Mara. Clearly, you're still bad. They just want Han to die. I don't think they even care whether Han is good or not. They just want him to kill himself. I guess they didn't try that with Mara.
I feel so bad for him.
Yeah. Han, like, he deserved better.
In the later game, you can force push the droid Akas and make them spin backwards.
That's cool.
You might be able to do this in this one too, I don't remember.
I thought the Mortis arc was so cool back when I was young or younger.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
It featured lightsabers, red lightning.
Mm-hmm.
Red lightning was Vader cool. In Clone Wars. Remember?
I think that.
Yeah, I never cared for
that. Yeah, it had the like Revenge of the Sith flashbacks.
Yeah.
Or flash.
And people thought that
was
epic, and then you compared it to the Tartakovsky show with the great dream sequence.
Which wasn't that epic either.
It was pretty epic. It was more symbolic. It was better done in every way
possible.
I mean,
I would lie if I say I watched that show for the symbolism and character development.
Mm. True. The doctor looked nice, I guess.
Oh, the hangar.
I disagree.
I just thought the Vader Anakin stuff was so deep. Yeah, I think a lot of children did that.
Remember that at some point I have to rewatch all of TCW. Maybe we should do that on, like, instead on YouTube, we're going to do that on Discord together.
I mean, I've told you that I'm willing to watch all those episodes with you.
Yeah, you can suffer with me.
I would,
but no, I like I'll the show, so.
I like it too. It'll be great.
Hmm.
I mean, I watched it the other day.
Why?
Because my dad wanted to watch it with me. We watched the Quinlan Voss episode.
A.K.A. Oh, yeah. Quinlan Lebowski.
Yep.
Surfer boy.
Yeah. And none it's of us
just like your opinion, man.
Wait, what?
It's a literal quote.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh no, I almost killed the pilot.
Yeah, that happens.
Yeah, I saw the scene and I told my dad that that's an infamous quote, usually quoted by infamous YouTuber Quality Autism, aka Noah Biolip, author of The Ultimate Phrenology.
Yeah.
A book that everybody should buy immediately.
A book that my dad doesn't like because of the trouble he got me into to buy it.
Oh no! No! Okay.
A book that is, by admission, incomplete and incorrect.
It is complete. The only thing missing may be TCW, but who cares?
It is complete. The only thing missing is that's kind of contrary statements.
Also, you still have two intros in that one book, and that's... Still...
No. That's fixed. That's your copy. That's your early copy. I already fixed it, so don't blame
me. Are you going to send me a new one, a correct one?
No. I'll buy you the second time if you want to.
No.
I mean, not including TCW is acceptable.
Yeah.
Even though you included
I didn't include Wood Wars, and I didn't include Supernatural Encounters because it's non-canon.
Well, because Wood Wars he didn't was get never it... canon.
Yeah, and because he didn't get it out on time, and most of the information in there was just like, I don't know.
Oh, you didn't include reference... the Hand of Thrawn 45's fanfic?
No, I did reference Supernatural Encounters elements, like,
the Celestials.
I guess.
But they are kind of in the Lando Adventures.
When you release the Indiana Jones chronology, will you have like a text box on the cover saying, including like secret Star Wars lore or something, because you're including the One Tail story?
Oh, yeah, sure. I wonder if Joe Bongiorno has made that one canon for real in Supernatural Encounters, probably.
I mean, given how long it's taken, he better include some cool stuff.
Yeah, wasn't it supposed to be printed like 3 weeks ago? And
wasn't it supposed to be finished in a month, like 5 years ago?
7 years ago, you know. In 2018, and then 2019, and then 2020, and then 2021.
I think it's just the nicer George R. R. Martin.
Now, did Josh ever watch Dr. Sucker?
Oh yeah, he did. He loved it. He said he's gonna watch it again with a fresh pair of eyes because he expected something different at first.
Okay, because I was gonna ask, what's gonna happen first? Joe releases the book, or Josh watches Dr. Sucker?
Well, he did, and now he's gonna watch Once Upon a Time in America. The movie we will never watch on Discord because of Liv, because she can't handle it.
And because it glorifies rape.
According to Jeremy, it does that, apparently.
Oh yeah, Fabe appreciates your thumbnail, Noah.
Thank you. It took me like 2 minutes and a bad Photoshop to make.
Oh, speaking of nothing, so I read more of The Paradise Snare.
Mm-hmm.
And it was really cool because it had this stupid element where two characters talk and a third character overhears the two characters talk, but he misunderstands everything.
Oh, yeah.
And then he gets angry for no reason, and then we have to have a scene where they're angry, and then one character has to explain it all. But thankfully, they resolved that plot line in five pages.
Mm-hmm. Which is the only acceptable way to resolve that kind of plot line.
Yeah, the best way is, of course, not having it in the first place, but...
Yes.
This one's fine. Otherwise, the book is still good, which is fun.
Mm-hmm.
I hope it doesn't become bad.
It doesn't.
How many pages do you even have left?
100.
Oh, okay.
Last thing that happened was Han and the Esselastan went to Nal Hatta to talk with not Jabba the Hutt.
Mm. Oh, I see.
And they sent the peace offering, which was just a hologram of the...
I just briefly had my face there, yeah.
That God happened. Damn it, and I missed it because I was busy playing.
But you know what he looks like.
I know.
Wait, why was Liv removed?
My internet kicked me out.
Okay, that's great. I'm glad I came back on here. Okay.
Thanks.
Yeah, talk for a minute. I'm going to take a quick break.
Okay.
Liv, if you get removed... Oh, you did. Okay.
I did.
Okay. Oh, and Alex also did, like an hour ago.
Yeah, but he never came back. So, that's something.
Yeah, so they went to this planet, and they exchanged a peace offering gift with the Hutt, and it was just a hologram of the leader of Elysia threatening the Hutt. Mm-hmm. And then the Hutt gets angry, so now he's going to declare war with Elysia. So that's cool. Didn't go well.
That happens.
And then that one chick is going to marry some pervert old guy.
Oh, yeah. Which chick exactly? The chick?
Bria.
Oh, yeah.
I think she's the chick. I've heard about a chick, and I guess it's her.
There's chicks in that, yeah.
Because I've heard that there's a romance with Han and someone else, and it's acceptable, even though it's not Leia.
Yeah.
What is
yeah.
up with that? How come Han is getting romances with people that aren't Leia?
Well, he was young and he didn't know Leia.
Oh.
Okay, I'm back. What are you talking about?
It's not like Leia who got a romance with a guy while she was also with Han.
She did?
She was supposed to.
Dear
yeah,
God.
It's a thing in a great book called The Courtship of Princess Leia.
Oh, what? Not only that.
Oh, not yeah, that so, okay. one.
Yeah, so in Courtship of Princess Leia, Leia cheats on Han. But no, actually, even before that, she was supposed to get Prince Caesar as a romance partner.
Oh,
that
well,
which doesn't happen,
that.
You fucking asshole, you fucking retard. He tries to rape her in the book. That's
yeah,
what
okay. But I was explaining what was actually the plan
supposed
of Lucasfilm.
To happen.
Yeah, I never
wow.
said it did happen. I said it was supposed to happen.
Thankfully, sensible Stephen Perry just settled for a rape scene instead.
Exactly.
Yeah.
He was
keeping it family friendly. He knew the fans would be upset.
Yeah,
I wonder why they would be upset by a rape scene. Or by...
No, fans would be upset by the love triangle, but they would be fine with an attempted rape.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, and by the way, Liv, this all happens when Han is frozen in carbonite in Jabba's palace.
But to be fair, Leia does kick him in the balls.
Yeah, after being caught by Chewbacca, and if he wasn't there, that scene would have just continued.
Lovely.
She was literally roofied. She was on drugs during that scene.
Yeah.
Okay. Now we come to the best level.
I remember this Lego Darth Maul when they didn't have like the horn piece.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, this one's better.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's old, you see, and it's better because of that.
Yeah, because it's old. I remember buying a Lego TCW set because it had like the Lego minifigure of Maul with the robot legs. And I thought that was cool. And then the legs broke like immediately.
Maybe that was a
sign. Because these like sea clam elements are just shit. They never.
Yeah, like I said, maybe that was just a sign.
So a pet peeve of mine with the Phantom Menace is that the soundtrack is allegedly great, but if you listen to the official soundtrack, it's not in the same order as in the movie.
Oh.
Hmm. That's weird.
Of course you would know that.
Yeah, because I like soundtracks. And listening to soundtracks.
Sid, you just know all of this stuff about literally everything.
So there was this one time where I was on a flight to, I believe it was Greece, and we didn't have film on this flight because it was to Greece, but I did have my phone. So I thought, maybe I'm going to watch a movie, and then I realized, no, that's going to take a bunch of internet. So I decided to just listen to Spotify. And the thing I listened to was just the entire Howard Shore Lord of the Rings soundtrack.
Nice.
Oh, I've done that before.
Yeah, and because I've seen the movie a million times, just listening to the soundtrack makes me see the pictures in my head.
Yeah.
So I essentially watched the entire
movie. That for me, yeah.
Yeah, it would be, but the soundtrack isn't in order. So with Lord of the Rings, I essentially just watched the movie because it's all in order. It's all equally long as the movie, so I can see everything and I can hear all the dialogue. But with Star Wars, if I have to watch the Darth Maul fight using Spotify, I have to start with it with one soundtrack and then switch over to another one and then go back to the first one, but another part of it.
So what you need to do is you need to get Noah, who has unlimited money, to pay for your Spotify premium, and then you can make your own playlist.
No,
order.
You don't understand. The first part of the mall fight is the doors opening, and he's standing there. That song is called Qui-Gon's Noble End.
Yes.
And then it goes over to a song called Duel of the Fates, but not the start of Duel of the Fates, the end of Duel of the Fates. And then it goes over to the start of Duel of the Fates. And then it goes over to the end of Qui-Gon's Noble End. So unless Spotify Premium allows me to cut in the songs and make my own song.
Which it doesn't.
It does.
Which it doesn't. Then Spotify Premium won't help me.
What the fuck? That's so bizarre.
It's because the soundtrack wasn't written with the movie in mind, which John Williams has actually complained about. He didn't know what he was doing because there was no story to attach the soundtrack to. So he just made, that's why like every song is just epic. And then they cut it up and just paste it to the movie.
You know what?
The reason that the soundtrack was good is because it didn't have Star Wars to go with it.
Yeah.
Yes.
You know what other music was written without the movie in mind? The entire Dollars trilogy.
Of course it was.
Yeah, and that's why it's just epic. But it's not like thematically relevant to the story.
Right.
I would say it is. Oh, you're talking the Star Wars soundtrack? In that case,
no, I'm talking the Morricone soundtrack.
No, that's very relevant.
Okay, I'm going to give you an example of what a relevant theme would be. So there's this great movie. It's called Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban. That just made me cry, seeing correct. Those blue studs fall over the ledge.
Yeah.
Shut the fuck up.
And in the Prisoner of Azkaban, there's this song called A Window to the Past. And it plays in the movie at several points where the story has to get something across. Mm-hmm. And it's great. That doesn't happen in The Phantom Menace.
Because, well, does The Phantom Menace have anything of relevance to say?
Yeah, it doesn't have a theme.
Yeah. Well, speaking of Shadows of the Empire, as I was talking to Kalba about fitting the Marvel series into Shadows of the Empire, I checked your chronology. Is there just no chapter on it? All I see is a reading order after the Tarkin chapter. Noah, that was for you.
What? I didn't hear you. The music was too loud.
Okay, so there's this guy named Pico Seconds, and he read your chronology, but it didn't find the Shadows of the Empire chapter.
called Black Sun. Right?
Or maybe specifically meant the Marvel series.
That's everything before that and after it a bit.
Well, there you go, I guess. That's your answer.
Wait, I want some more money.
Or does he mean he couldn't find a timeline?
Maybe he meant that.
Pico, you're going to have to explain this.
It's not there.
What is it? The chapter?
Like just everything?
What? Like you don't have the chronology? That sounds like a you problem.
That is a bizarre shape.
Or do you mean the novel It is not there?
That is good. It means you don't have to read game.
The chapter called Black Sun.
It apparently is not there. Well, that's unfortunate.
Well, Noah, you're going to have to look into this.
Like, are you looking at the German PDF that I put into the server?
Well, he said, yeah, I guess.
He'll show on VC later before the movie.
He doesn't want to expose you on stream. Okay, here we go. I like how Noah just rushed through this level, not caring about the stats.
Yep.
I like how he pretended for like a minute that he actually would like to collect all the stats.
I mean, I guess it's a sign of a healthy mind that you don't have to collect every single stud.
Mm-hmm.
It's also a sign of being rich. When you're rich, you don't care about losing a euro. Yep. But when you're poor, like me and Jaylight,
You have to.
Yeah, every penny matters.
Yeah.
What? The song you're hearing right now is called Qui-Gon's Noble End.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I did know that.
It was a noble end, yeah. His arm fell down his body, and then it was on his body again while he was dead already. But
is that a thing?
I think it is. Not. Gonna look up his death.
And also, his legs fell out of the socket, apparently.
Oh.
I wonder why they gave Maul an extra long lightsaber if they're not going to animate him holding it with two hands.
Yes.
That was sad.
Lego deaths are indeed very sad.
Can someone like post that scene but edit in the Alex death sound instead?
Do that, please. Yes.
So now, are we gonna keep going until you completed the prequels?
I don't know. Can I skip the credit, the fucking cutscene?
I don't think so. It's an old Lego game.
Okay. I like how this skips the entire, Gungan battle sequence, and we don't know who won or lost or whatever happened.
Yeah, who cares?
Well, they're all there, so you assume that they won.
Yeah. Isn't the Anakin level, like, an Easter egg or something you can unlock?
It might be a bonus level, I'm not sure.
You know, this is my first time seeing anything related to LEGO Star Wars, the video game. Like, I've never played it or did any of that. I've never even watched anything related to it. Yeah.
Oh my god, you missed out on life.
I know. I know.
We finished Phantom Menace. Oh wait, Phantom Menace is finished?
Now you're gonna build R2?
I don't know.
And do the bonus level, yeah. I guess.
Oh no, not the bonus.
Oh, you can also unlock Indiana Jones in this, which again confirms shared universe.
Mm-hmm. You can do it now, by the way.
Unlock him?
Yeah, all you have to do is like watch the trailer.
Oh, we have to watch the trailer. No, then I don't want to. What can I already do with the character creator?
Hello,
you can do a lot with it. I think you can even give it a red lightsaber and make it a Sith.
Yeah, I think so too. You might even give him a double lightsaber.
What I know do you do, Noah?
I'm random. Just doing random.
You just made him a monstrosity.
Yeah, that happens when you press random.
It is Noah, after all.
Oh my god, okay, I want to create a Gungan Jedi.
Why would you want to do that? You know you can just change it.
I know. I want to keep randomizing until the Gungan shows up again.
You know that may, in theory, take forever.
I don't care.
Noah doesn't want to watch the fucking thing to get the Indiana Jones thing, but he wants to push random for...
No, that was... Okay, fuck it. We're just gonna...
Yeah, maybe give yourself a cooler weapon.
Well, give him hair also.
Oh, I can give him... Okay. I can't give him anything.
You can give him hair like that.
It's just gonna float in the air, so I'm not gonna do that.
No, it's not gonna. It's just not gonna be...
He needs that's a Jedi body. He needs a good... What is a good Jedi?
Oh, just make him naked.
I guess this is a Jedi-ish. He needs beige arms. Is that the color?
No, that's another color.
Is it his skin color?
I think it's just skin color, not his skin color.
Okay, and what... He gets brown like his shirt.
Okay.
Unless I can find beige.
I mean, there was beige, but you just go back. Ah, it was right there.
Here it is.
We'll say so, yes.
Is that brown? I'm colorblind. Does this
that is
match?
Brown.
Yeah, it looks.
It does match, looks... yes.
Yeah, that matches.
Okay. Now for the cape. Cape. Brownish?
Sure.
Okay. How do I name him?
Yeah, Fremder 1. That's a good name.
I think that's just his name.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, can you save by pressing U, I guess? Oh, it was right there.
Yeah, I did. I saved.
No. Go back in. K. Press K.
Oh, okay. Let's call him...
Alphonse Adler.
Yeah. Alphonse is not a weird name.
Hitler.
You could do that.
Oh, here we go. When you wrote Gar, I thought you were going to name him Gar Stasi.
Oh,
which would be a disrespect.
I could create Gar Stasi because they have the fucking species in here.
What is Stasi? Is he a
Duras?
Duras, yeah. Duras. How do I make this empty?
Just keep scrolling. In case you don't know, Alphonse Hattler is the name of Noah's KOTOR character.
Oh, okay. Thank you, Sid.
It is also Adolf's father.
No, that was Alois.
Oh, true, Alois. It was Alphonse.
As we can see, Noah does not know the alphabet.
Indeed.
No, he does not.
Alois, yeah, true. He's from your corner there.
Should I name him Alois Hitler? as a reference.
Is well, it the same? Is it the same amount of letters? Otherwise, you have to move it all.
Yeah, no, it isn't.
No, it isn't. Okay, let's keep it Alphonse Hitler. Okay. Okay, now I want to make Gastasi.
Yeah, just take the other. Yeah, exactly.
It's a shame you can only make two. Oh, there he is. Okay.
Hello, fine editions.
I need to unlock more characters and then I get more options.
That is true.
Oh, look at this one.
Is that... What is that? Is that Ada Secura? But that
wouldn't make sense.
But you don't have the character.
I know, it's weird. Okay, what is a good military look for him?
Nah, you should have stuck with Ada Secura and made him a stripper.
I guess white?
Guys, I have good news.
Yeah.
Okay.
My dad, he has to do a meeting later, so I have another reason to skip movie night once again.
No!
Very good.
I'm Sivir. I have good news. It's actually shit news, which means he's going to miss out on the movie for like the umpteenth time.
What can I buy already?
Don't buy anything. You can buy Darth Maul.
Oh. Okay.
But you don't need to.
You could also just say for the extras our normal.
Yeah, just so you know, the times 10 red brick costs, I believe it's 40 million.
Yeah.
Let me check. But I don't have the brick.
That is true. You don't have the brick. It's in the original trilogy levels.
Yeah, and arguably it would make more sense to get a lower multiplicator.
It's so expensive with this game. The times 2-1 costs 2 million. The times 4-1 is the most difficult one. It costs, I believe it's 6 million.
Hmm.
That's a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Should I just play the original trilogy instead? But, okay.
I mean, it's better. It does mess with my OCD, though.
I know.
Why is that?
You know what? I'm looking forward to playing the bounty hunter missions for Jabba. I remember this being very fun.
I remember it not being very fun. See, the reason why it messes with my OCD is that there's this thing called characters. And as you might have seen, when Noah completes a level, he gets this grid where it unlocks a bunch of characters.
Mm-hmm.
And they are ordered in the order you unlock them if you play it all chronologically. So if you place the original trilogy, they're going to show up in the middle of the grid and not like...
Oh.
It's not going to be the next one.
That makes sense.
Would you play as Grievous in here? No, right?
Yes, you can.
Yes. Oh my god, that's awesome.
And he's the best character because you can jump higher than any other character.
I prefer Ghost.
I think Gungan. Can't Gungans jump up to the same
height? Yeah, but Grievous can jump even higher.
Oh, well, that's cool.
How come?
Because he's awesome. Machine.
Wait, let me jump with Jar Jar. So this is Jedi. This is normal people jump. Jedis can do this. And where's Jar Jar? He's inside.
To the right, I believe.
Wait, let me go inside.
Okay, sure, but he wasn't there.
There he is.
Oh, there he is.
Okay, Jedi can jump until here, and Jar Jar is like...
It's a bit higher, even though.
It's a bit higher.
Yeah.
It's just the bit that you miss when you encounter the places only he can reach.
Yep.
Oh, fun fact. Let me check if this works.
That's nice, I guess.
Yeah, yeah, that's a nice little thing. Now I don't like get a copyright off. Strike. Yeah.
There are some games where like game sound effects is part of the music. So if you turn off the music, it also won't have sound effects.
Wait, can we create Darth Tenebrous?
Yes, because
you have a bit.
Yes. Okay, now I need the Darth Maul outfit for this to look convincing. And the red lightsaber. So yeah, I have to play more.
Indeed.
Everyone's favorite character, Darth Tenebrous.
Mm-hmm. I remember him from the first third of that book. Or even less.
Not even the first third, the first chapter.
Oh yeah, that's true. Yeah, what's that short story?
Could we like pay someone to make a Lego game of the multimedia project?
The expanded universe, that would be fun. We have Starkiller already. Anything else in like Force Unleashed 3?
No EU.
Not though. Force Unleashed 3, what am I talking? Lego Star Wars 3.
But imagine like a game in the style of Lego Star Wars 3, but it's the multimedia project.
That would be cool.
It would indeed be cool.
I hate this level, I don't want to play it.
Well,
is where you have to chase Sam Wessel through Coruscant.
But is it really worse than the first level in Revenge of the Sith?
Wait.
Oh, yeah, play the first one in Revenge of the Sith. You're not going to like it.
Oh, wait, I remember. No, that one is on rails, essentially. That's easier.
Okay, well, let's play it, though.
No.
Battle of Coruscant.
I think I'm done for today, but yeah.
The Revenge of the Sith one has a Wilhelm scream every time you die.
What does New Hope open with? Oh, just in... Yeah, 10-4.
Kind of planning, yeah. 10-4.
And Empire opens with really annoying Hoth level.
Hoth, obviously.
Oh, yeah. That opens with Jabba's Palace.
And then Return is Jabba's Palace.
Yeah, but Jedi Schicksal, that was my favorite one, usually.
Yeah, because you can fight against Palpatine with Vader and Luke. That was fun.
Yeah, that was really nice.
You know, the new game, Skywalker Saga, isn't made for two players.
That's really bad.
So with the Mustafar fight, like in this game, it's clever because you play as both Obi-Wan and Anakin, then you have to fight each other.
Mm-hmm.
In the Skywalker Saga, player one plays as Obi-Wan fighting Anakin. Player two is R2-D2 hovering on some platform and just waiting for player one to finish the level.
Oh, yeah. I think I see.
Awesome.
That sounds really boring.
Yeah, because it's not made for dual player, unfortunately. Even though that's the funniest part of the game.
It's basically the entire audience.
What happens if you're playing as Anakin and you beat the person playing as Obi-Wan?
Then...
I think you just have to continue. Yeah, you have to continue until Obi-Wan wins.
Oh, great.
Noah would have to play that at some point. There is a PS2 game for Revenge of the Sith where you play through the entire game. And there is an alternative level where you fight as Anakin against Obi-Wan and you get an alternative ending to Revenge of the Sith. So that's cool.
Ooh, that sounds fun.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I can already buy Jango for some reason.
It's fun because
and the Dooku, game... And Grievous.
Oh, you can buy Grievous. Hmm? The best character in the game.
And the Stormtrooper. And Greedo. That's random as hell. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the game was great, actually. It came out before the movie, so you had the entire story of the movie.
There he is! Why? How?
I guess you...
I already watched the trailer. Should I buy him?
Why would you? He doesn't even have a revolver. He has a laser gun.
Does he?
Yeah.
I'm buying Indiana Jones right now.
But you're not playing free mode, so what did you even buy him for?
Well, he's going to walk around in the bar now. Or the cantina, I guess it's called.
When does he show up? I want to see him right now.
Yeah, you have to look.
Oh, it's going to be symbolic.
Yeah, he is.
You're passing the torch to Indy as you're starting to...
No, look, that's
the
gun.
He actually has bullets. That's awesome.
And the sound effect for it.
Ironically, in the Lego Indy game, he doesn't even have a gun.
Oh my god, instead of punching people, he uses his whip. Qui-Gon is attacking Indy.
The death sound in the cantina, they were funny as hell.
Yeah, that's another thing, Liv. If you attack someone, you start like a bar fight.
Yeah.
Really?
Like that's the bar cool. fight in the Crystal Skull.
Yeah.
That was a great scene.
It was. Mm-hmm.
I've never played the Lego Indy game.
You've never played the Lego Indy game?
Oh.
Well, because you're... Yeah, you just switched to Indy. It's like you passing the torch to Indy, and now you're gonna do Indy chronology and play Lego Indy.
Very nice. Oh no! It was only Jar Jar. Don't... Shit.
Oh yeah, you even had the red bricks where you can give Ewoks instead of like hurling stones there through torpedoes instead.
And they're OP.
Yeah, that was funny as hell.
I love the gun sound effect.
Yeah. But yeah, the Revenge of the Sith game, man, that was actually good. I think it still had one of the best lightsaber combats ever in a Star Wars game. And you got movie scenes before the movie was even out. That was cool.
And also scenes that aren't in the movie, like the Anakin Shakti fight.
True, yeah. You get to have a boss fight as Anakin against Mace Windu. That was kind of cool.
Should have happened in the movie.
Oh, yeah. Fuck!
I think that's an anecdote that Ryan Kimmel always randomly brings up, is that he played the game, and so he thought it would be in the movie, and he hyped up all his friends, and then it didn't happen to be in the movie. And so they were kind of mad. But it's true. It should have been in the movie.
At least we got the lamest fight in the movie.
What? Mace Windu and Palpatine?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was kind of underwhelming.
Because it's two old people.
Yeah. And it doesn't really sell you Mace Windu as a great sword fighter. He just looks vaguely angry, and I guess that's him using the Vapart.
Imagine if they even put that much thought into it. Yeah, he also does this thing where he like goes out, he like puts his arms out like he's doing a vampire stance and scaring him.
Oh yeah. Yeah, I think that was just Samuel L. Jackson pulling a face. It wasn't really even... I don't believe it.
No, are you like going to play a level or something?
No, I think I'm done for today. We're going to watch a movie later.
Yeah, like in an hour and a half.
You still have an hour, yeah.
Like you may as well start another episode at least.
But I hate this level.
Yeah, but then start one that you don't hate.
Yeah, play Revenge of the Sith.
Yes, but also, please.
I'm going to play the New Hope.
Yeah, okay, that one's cool.
But that's longer.
Yeah, but the Tentafor isn't a bad level.
Okay, Attack of the Clones, Revenge of the Sith.
Yeah, just do Attack of the Clones.
Well,
then.
You hate one of them and you don't hate the other one. So, should be an easy choice.
That is true.
I'm thinking.
We can see.
I also jump around when I'm thinking.
Mm-hmm. Usually. It helps you, you know. Gets the blood going.
Yeah, down to your feet.
Mm-hmm. The brain's literally moving. That helps.
Okay, fuck it. We played a bad level.
Nice. I mean, The speed off Sam Wessel is still one of the coolest sound effects I've ever heard, I have to say. It really sounds
cool. I actually turned all the music off. That's nice.
Except this music, apparently.
Cutscene music, yeah.
Out of all the mistakes Obi-Wan made, cutting his mallet was the worst one.
Oh my god, I know. His hair was absolutely fantastic in that one.
Shouldn't it have been Anakin diving through the window and Obi-Wan taking the speeder?
Oh look, both of them are taking speeders now. This is canon. Oh
but
no.
I mean, Obi-Wan, I mean, Anakin is the rash one, so shouldn't he be the one diving through the window?
Can I drive faster somehow?
But I think try pressing A.
But I think he would like to stay with Padme more than that. Yeah, that might be it.
But he doesn't stay with her, he is... Well, I guess it's because Obi-Wan dives through the window.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess she wasn't wearing any clothes, so maybe he wanted to shake her out.
Yeah. They had a quickie until he jumped into a speeder. Oh yeah, I forgot what a great level that was.
Oh, I hate these things. I hate these so much.
All right.
I remember this from the movie, totally.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Yeah, him not collecting the stats is really painful. Oh no, the blue stat. Please take the blue.
Shut up! You know how difficult this is?
Yes, I played this game many years ago.
We've all played this game, Noah, yes.
Okay, how do I collect?
That doesn't change.
No, drive through this. How do I collect? Wait.
You have to find something you need to shoot at.
Okay. Give me the money!
That's a classic.
Okay. Did I do it?
Well, you did something.
Mm-hmm.
I have to destroy these things. How do
try driving over the torpedo thing, but not like left to right, but the other way.
Ah! Somehow the controls are garbage. Okay.
Now it's everyone's favorite game mechanic.
Oh yeah. Well, the torpedoes work better than the bombs on Hoth.
Yeah, the bombs on Hoth are the worst. I thought he missed for a second.
Just want some of those stats. Just some of them.
This was also when collecting studs was hard. Like I know in the Empire Strikes Back level, you lose 4,000 every time you die.
Hmm.
And you never get them back.
Yeah.
What do I
think?
Wait, there she goes.
What wait, flying wait. Levels don't suck? I guess the Death Star runs aren't that horrible.
The first one isn't bad.
Yeah.
And the second one is cool, I guess.
The asteroid field and Empire Strikes Back. I don't remember that being really good.
All my stats.
And he's not gonna be able to get them back because the controls are so bad.
Yeah, I got 3 or 4, so that's good. Okay.
I wish I had any like interesting lore to talk about, but it's Attack of the Clones, and there's nothing interesting about it.
Should we watch TCW? We watched the TCW movie recently. If you guys want to, we can start live. Instead of Korra, we watch TCW, and then we just bitch about it for a couple of hours.
Yes, no, we praise it for the masterpiece it is.
I want to watch TCW.
Oh my god, this is both sides!
Yep, it gets harder.
Great, just what I wanted.
The first episodes of TCW aren't that bad because they don't retcon anything.
Oh, shut up! I need to find the blue studs! Where's my blue? Blue studs! No!
Okay. Oh, you got them all.
That's kind of impressive.
Yeah, this just gives me flashbacks to the pain of collecting studs in this game.
Mm-hmm. I'm proud of myself beating this when I was a child.
By the way, no, if you crash into something, you do lose a heart.
Yeah, I just realized that. No! Stop shooting at me!
Yadlet, have you read the Jedi Quest?
Jedi Quest, I have not, no. I have not read any YA stuff so far, unless you count Jedi Prince, I guess.
That's unfortunate, because I read Jedi Quest the other day.
No!
Oh, you did? Okay.
But I don't have anyone to talk about it with, because I can't talk to Noah. I read a book from Jedi Quest.
Which one, and why didn't you read it in order?
What do you mean?
Was it the first one? What books?
No, I already read the first one.
Oh, okay, so you read it in order then?
Yes.
Fly through this? Okay.
I don't know where you got the idea that I didn't from.
I don't know. But which one did you read?
I think it's called... Wait, I'll just see what... Because I read... There's Jedi Quest Zero, which I already read.
Yeah.
Then there's... I read The Trail of the Jedi.
Oh, okay. That's book three, I think.
It's book two, three, if you count Zero as number one.
Yeah, if we count Zero.
It was the worst one so far, but it was still decent.
What is Jedi Quest Zero? Is that like?
That's just called Jedi Quest. I think it's called the. What is the
Path
subtitle?
To Truth.
Path to Truth. Yeah, it's like an introduction to the series, and then book one actually starts. It is book one by all accounts, but for some reason they call it book zero.
It's really good. That one was my favorite.
Path to Truth, der Pfad der Erkenntnis.
Yeah. It's basically Anakin stumbling upon a guy from Tatooine who used to make his life living hell.
I see. I want to see if I have that one, actually. I don't think I have.
And then Jedi Quest 1 was good, but it had, what's he called, Anakin Solo. What's his name?
Skywalker? Anakin Skywalker?
No, Anakin Solo, but allegedly Anakin Solo character. What's he called? Serious Apprentice.
Paris Olin?
Yeah, that's his name.
You know, isn't that Jason according to Star Wars Theory?
Maybe. It's Anakin Solo according to Spidey fan.
Oh, I see. Yeah, I just looked. We had Omnibus for Jedi Quest in
Boss
German.
Boss fight with terrible controls.
And it is in there. It is in there, so... I have it, thankfully.
I did it! Fuck.
Good job.
Yeah, you should read both Jedi Apprentice and Jedi Quest.
I have heard only good things about it, yeah.
I mean, it's a junior novel, and it's apparent. Especially in Jedi Apprentice, from what I've read. There's a plot twist in every book.
Yeah, but... If it's just, like, a bit juvenile and not just...
Dude, don't fucking shit-talk Jude Watson. Those are better written than some adult novels.
Yeah, well, I don't shit-talk.
Yeah, I agree.
Europe got Omnis of Jedi Quest. Yeah, we got. Because I
have them printed. Have I showed you the hardcovers I printed with Lulu? I got fucking Galaxy of Fear in two hardcovers now.
Yeah, well, you talked about that, yeah.
Yeah, that's something you should read, Galaxy of Fear. Okay, the next...
But not before Jedi Apprentice or Jedi Quest.
Yeah, Pico, I just randomly got them because the young adult novels, they are all basically out of print. Like, I think so, at least. Some you get pretty easily, but I just found people on eBay who sold the entire series. And Jedi Apprentice, I got the singles. And yeah, Jedi Quest, I got as omnibuses. Yeah, it's, wait, four. It's four omnibuses, yeah.
Oh, I really enjoyed it. Clues is a based book series, Pico.
Wait, what?
39 Clues.
Yeah, I don't know that.
Well, Jedi Apprentice was good, I think.
I've heard it's good, so yeah.
Especially the latter half.
Mm-hmm. Jedi Quest is supposedly very good. There's, what's it called? Secrets of the Jedi and Legacy of the Jedi or something? I don't know.
The Legacy of the Jedi is first. That's the Dooku backstory. And then Secrets of the Jedi is the payoff for the love story with Obi-Wan and Ciri, which Matt Wilkins thinks is terrible. Because he has terrible opinions.
Yeah, well, that was during Twins. So he was cranky at the time.
I guess so. And yeah, Last of the Jedi, I'm not sure. I've heard mixed stuff about that.
It's good. I recommend it. First gay Star Wars character.
I mean, yeah, it has Ferris Olin, and he sucks from what I've read, which is one book. But he did suck in that. He's like Draco Malfoy.
Oh, I see. So, okay. Gay and a dick.
He's also a snitch. Just like Draco Malfoy, I guess.
There you go. Oh, Fabi's. Yeah, of course, Fabi. I'm sure Fabi's insulted by that.
Wait, Noah, when was Ferris Olin officially gay?
When? Let me finish for today because I made progress.
Oh, yes, Fabi. I know so many girls, like back in, like when we were 15, they made edits of Draco Malfoy. It was so. It was cringe. Very cringe.
Oh yeah, Tumblr loves the Draco Malfoy. I remember those.
They simped real bad.
Isn't he?
Ferris is officially canon gay. He literally is in. Read the fucking Last of the Jedi series. He's 100% gay.
Oh,
is that when he was confirmed gay?
Wait, let me look up the Jude Watson.
Or does Fabi believe it's like a J.K. Rowling Dumbledore thing?
No, it's apparent in the book.
I see.
It's just not outright stated because those were written for children.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if you ask Karen Travis, she made the first gay Star Wars character.
Yeah, of course she did, in her mind, because she doesn't read Star Wars books. Okay, yeah. Let me check.
You're looking for Ferris Olin being gay?
Yeah, when she confirmed it. So the first thing that Wikipedia at least links is a tweet by her. And I'm trying, it's loading. Yeah, well.
But Last of the Jedi came out in like 2005, 2006.
She confirmed it here in 2015.
Well, yeah, well, but if it's apparent in the books, then...
It is apparent in the books, yeah.
So it should be confirmed like 2006 or something.
If she just says it, that's kind of
mean. It's just she didn't say it. It was in response to someone asking about it.
I guess.
Someone who didn't read the books. Maybe it's Spidey fan.
Don't even compare. Okay, Fabi, I'm gonna ban you from the server for comparing Jude Watson to Chuck Wendy.
No, if you ban Fabi, then you're gonna be like, eventually you're gonna run out of people to ban.
I know, but that's just insulting.
I mean, Chuck Wendig and Jude Watson, I guess they're both feminine.
Oh, say. Count Travis. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, sure. Travis and Wendig would get along very well.
I don't think they would. I mean, Wendig is pretty masculine. He kills people. He has a shed. He has an axe.
Mm.
I guess he does.
I'm trying to think. Did we finish the Matt Wilkins rant about his terrible timeline? Because now I have the book in front of me.
I think you have, yeah.
I mean, I said that the Young Jedi Knights book at least takes place 20 years after A New Hope.
Oh yeah, because you found two direct like mentions of how many years have passed.
I found even more than two. I just only read two of them aloud. But at several points in the first two books, at least, they state that the Battle of Yavin was over 20 years ago.
Okay.
But I mean, I guess he could still push Hand of Thrawn to like 24 ABY.
Yeah, but that's specifically not what he wants to do.
He specifically wants to put Young Jedi Knights and Junior Jedi Knights before Hand of Thrawn, and Hand of Thrawn is in 19 ABY.
So what is worse? Is it Matt Wilkins not knowing that the timeline is fucked up, or is it others in the comments saying, oh yeah, the timeline is fucked up, but it still makes more sense in spirit?
I mean, Matt knows that it's fucked up. He just thinks that his version is the most salvageable one.
I see.
He thinks his version is superior for a problem that literally isn't a problem, that he read way too much into. It's like...
Yeah, I mean...
You know how people who hated the Russians still called them like Soviets? Like, that's basically what this is. And he thinks, oh, that means that's still the case.
Mm-hmm. I mean, we are... I brought up the comparison. We are at peace with the Taliban. Like, we're not in a war with them. But, mm-hmm. Yeah, I guess you would probably still consider them evil. But I will.
And he doesn't care that they call themselves the Second Imperium. I'm sorry, the New Imperium, as Matt Wilkins thinks they are called.
Well, he's close enough.
I mean, Breakis does. I forgot. Is Breakis and his Shadow Academy separate from the New Imperium?
No, the Second Imperium is made up of these Breakaway Imperials and the Shadow Academy. They are like the Force users for that.
Okay. Well, Breakis calls it Second Imperium, and the fake Emperor calls it the Empire. But he's also fake, so...
Yeah,
would make sense. But yeah, I've been shown a great scene from Young Jedi Knights where Lando takes Jaina on his ship. And I was not particularly impressed with that scene. But oh well.
Wow.
I think it was written a bit weirdly, at least for my tastes, I guess. The Holy Roman Empire also thinks they are the Roman Empire. Well, we were, thank you very much.
Yeah, they were neither Holy Roman nor an empire.
Yeah, that's a your opinion.
That is factual.
Sure.
You think it was an empire?
Well, it's something akin to an empire.
Don't know about that. You think it was Roman?
I'm sure there was Latin spoken in there at some point.
Is that enough to be considered Roman?
No. Sort of. I mean, the Catholic Church is still the Roman Catholic Church.
I don't think that that's how that works.
Yeah, I don't know.
Could we consider Sweden the Holy English Empire because there's English spoken in here?
I don't know. If you think Holy English Empire is something that sounds nice and like people would respect it, I don't think...
I guess it's kind of an oxymoron because it's holy and English.
Exactly. There, we agree. So, Noah, you like the Matt Wilkins talk we have here?
No, not at all. But yeah, we have to write down Matt's timeline, because he has more errors than just this.
You should just publish this as an own book. Why not? Make a network.
Where is his timeline? Didn't he have it online or somewhere?
Doesn't he have it on its website?
Let me check.
You would have to watch through all Matt Wilkins' videos and write down all the Wilkinisms as part of his actual timeline.
You know, Dawn of the Jedi is 25,000 years after A New Hope.
Exactly. It's the canonically last story, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I also told Matt that the Storyteller comic is actually canon and the last story he has to review. And I don't remember if he believed me.
That would be cool. And I think you might manage that, but you would have to. I would be down for it. We watch all Matt Wilkins' content and make notes about his timeline.
I'm not down for that, so you're going to have to do it without me.
That sounds like so much fun.
There's like 2,000 videos.
Yeah.
You guys have too much free time. Jeez.
EU reading order. Oh my god.
Well, you see, the trick is getting Noah to do all of this and pretending like we're going to be along for the ride, but we're just not.
Is this the list? Jesus. Wait, okay, let me check. Yep, this absolute fucking insane person has Junior Jedi Knights after Young Jedi Knights lightsabers.
Oh, there you go.
And so I believe he thinks it takes place during lightsabers, right?
I think so. Apes. That is, it's literally an entire year before Young Jedi Knights begins.
Well, apparently.
For some reason, he has no disintegrations, please, after Survivor's Quest.
I guess that is wrong.
Yeah, that one doesn't really have a strict timeline, but I don't know why he put it here.
The best one is still the fake Mara Jade conspiracy.
Oh yeah, that's famously.
He literally hasn't. Like, what did he name as a reason?
He never gave a reason. It's just the one character thinks, oh, that can't be that Mara Jade. And Matt just took her word for it, I guess. I don't know. It's bizarre.
Yeah, no, you're right. The character in universe is not sure whether it's Mara Jade or not. But it obviously just is.
Wow, he has last one standing actually at the correct spot, which is between Corellian Trilogy and Hand of Thrawn. But he didn't review it that way. Let me. I'm checking this right now. Yeah, so the Junior Jedi Knights era is in here. Let me check. Where does he put Boba Fett? Practical Man. Where would he put the crystal? Because here he has it where it belongs. Like, it takes place at the same time as the final Young Jedi Knights book, and Mara is already sick in it, which is, you know, leading into Vector Prime.
Maybe she was always sick.
Hmm. Then we get the Chewbacca comic and Invasion. Yeah.
If he fucks up the Invasion placement, I don't blame him at all.
Mm-hmm. Tales Revenants. Okay, that's wrong. I think that's after Dark Tide. But okay. Yeah, yes, Boba Fett Practical Man before Balance Point. That's good. Recovery, Conquest, Rebirth, Emissary of the Void. Force Heretic, Dark Nest, Imprint, Legacy of the Force. I mean, there isn't much room for him to do anything wrong now.
Has he done, like, the Rebellion and Clone Wars era?
Yeah, I think that's also on here. Should I check? Because that's going to be a nightmare.
Well, I mean, even if it's not like similar to your timeline, can we really say that it's wrong?
Yeah, I guess.
Because
yeah.
that would imply there's a right order, which there isn't.
Oh, he also has the legacy comics in the wrong order, because technically issue 8 comes first, because it's like an elongated flashback telling us what led to the events in issue 1.
Hmm.
True.
Okay, Legacy 2, let me check if he has Storyteller on there. Of course not, no. And the Heine Minis. So yeah, so he has a bunch of shit missing. Oh, there's Shadow Games, there's Rebel Dawn. The Empire comics.
It's probably the wrong order.
Bunch of Mos Eisley short stories, the Death Star novel, okay. I can't really blame him for Clone Wars or Rebellion, because those eras are nightmares.
I guess so.
Oh, he has Escape from Dagoo on there.
That's nice, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Oh, but also Darth Maul Death Sentence and Son of Dathomir, the TCW tie-ins.
Well, I thought you liked those. Didn't they imply that Darth Maul and Triclops are half-brothers?
Oh, Son of Dathomir did, yeah.
What a great theory.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, Liv, I guess Triclops, he is the son of Palpatine from Jedi Prince.
He has three eyes. He has three eyes, like two normal ones in the front and one in the back.
Yeah, and apparently, like, it's...
He's a pacifist.
And I think it's pretty clear that that Darth Maul is the son of Mother Talzin. And so, since there is a... There's a hint
that she and Palpatine may have had a thing in the past, so, yeah.
Which would make Darth Maul son of Palpatine.
It is implied. You can make fan theories. Yeah.
But I thought in Plagueis, the random lady brought Maul to Palpatine as a baby.
Yes. So in the Darth Plagueis book, what was she called? Kryna or something? That woman...
Yeah.
Was Maul's and Savage Oprah's mother, who wanted to protect him from Talzin. So she gave Maul to fucking Palpatine when he was on vacation on Dathomir or whatever. That was the backstory that was established at that point. And Lucino worked that in, you know, to play nice with TCW changing Darth Maul's backstory up. And then Filoni retconned himself again and was in the comics Son of Dathomir, which concludes the cliffhanger from TCW when it was cancelled the first time. He established, Mother Talzin is actually Darth Maul's, like, biological mother.
How?
I don't know. So I guess that woman in Plagueis was just lying. And now, because it's implied that Plagueis and Talzin somehow also knew each other beforehand, even though that also doesn't work with the Plagueis novel, yeah, so the implication is they fucked, and Maul is actually Palpatine's son.
That's terrifying. No.
Yeah.
I don't like that.
Mm-hmm. Welcome to TCW.
Which makes him Triclops' half-brother, because Triclops, his parents were Palpatine, and Slimua, the pale lady from the prequels.
Seriously?
Yeah, like his advisor lady, the bald one, the terrifying
one. Oh, the ugly one.
Yeah. Palpatine just likes ugly women. That's his fetish.
Mm-hmm.
Makes sense.
I finished Phantom Menace and the first level of Attack of the Clones, which was a terrible level.
So, like 10 more streams and then...
And Palpatine has another son in the Hungarian Han Solo novels. Merle. I think that's his name.
And I, yeah.
So we got Maul, Merle, and Triclops.
Yeah. And we have a bunch of rumored ones which weren't correct. So.
Oh, yeah. But the, those three are up there. They are correct. That's quite a family tree.
That's traumatizing.
But again, it just shows Star Wars is about family.
Family, yeah. It did the Fast and the Furious thing because before they did it, so.
That, no, that's what Karen Travis did in Legacy of the Force.
Man, you really hate Boba Family Fett.
Yes, he's the worst character.
Boba? Yeah, Karen Travis, Boba Fett.
Boba Fett is the worst character. Yeah, that version is the worst character ever.
He's all about family.
Would you say Boba Fett is worse than Kydus?
No, still not. Kydus.
Would you say he's worse than Dala?
Oh.
No. Oh no.
Lucas, yeah.
Magnino.
Would you say he's worse than the Lee Maror?
No.
So he's not the worst character ever.
If you think terrible characters are interesting, yeah, sure, you do you. Dala is a hero. Dala also fucked Boba. And he was like 78 years old.
Well, so was she.
Alex, you are boring. Leave.
Alex, come on and talk to us.
Yeah, Alex.
No.
I want to hear Noah yelling.
We have to stop now.
No, we don't. Give him the link.
No, Alex is here.
Oh, yeah, Alex, go to off topic. The link is there. Just join quick before Noah deletes the stream.
I'm going to delete the invite.
Yeah, good job, Magnino.
Why does Boba need to still be there after years?
Yeah. Can't he just die in the Sarlacc? Like,
I don't want.
Like, I'm fine with him dying in the Sarlacc.
I don't need Boba to still be a main focus.
Also, he's not the same character for 4 years.
All he can do is yell, you fucking retard.
Well, Magnino doesn't care about that.
Noah watch Book of Boba Fett? Noah, did you watch Book of Boba Fett?
Do you think he watched Book of Boba Fett?
No.
Yeah, there you go.
I really want to watch. I want to hear Noah watch Book of Boba Fett now.
He was boring before the Sarlacc. That's incorrect.
No, Boba from the original trilogy was cool because he just didn't say anything. And he killed people.
I mean, I wouldn't agree that he's the same character for 40 years.
Story before that. Last
was
one
he really
standing.
Great? Was he great?
Last one standing, better than anything Travis ever wrote.
Oh, yeah.
He's also different in TCW.
That is true. He's a whiny bitch boy in TCW.
Well, he's all right. Yeah, what is it? You said he sucks. Then he was always the same. Then he's most overrated, and now he's all right. Boba from Blood Ties, 10 out of 10. Do you agree with that, Noah? I don't think Noah's listening.
No,
my internet is dying.
Yeah, right.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
My internet is dying. Can you guys even hear me?
Yes, we can. But I think you're bullshitting us because they don't want to talk about Magnino anymore, which I understand.
Join the stream, Magnino. Let's make Noah pissed off.
Alex, Darth Vader is the worst character. He's a terrible character, Alex.
I need money.
It's about family, Alex. Yeah, indeed. Fucking family.
Well, at least Alex admitted
Alex,
that
Alex,
they were
listen,
interesting
Alex,
things
shut
in
the
Blood
fuck
Ties.
Up. Shut the fuck up. Alex, how about this? You don't use Boba Fett at all in the stories. Why? Why do you have Boba Fett running around at 78 years old? Why? Why? Why would you even make him a main character again?
Yeah, he's one of the two characters I know who should have died in the Sarlacc. So, there you go. We could have just kept him there.
Alex never has good arguments.
We know.
Alex, you are the biggest retard I know. I wish you would legitimately kill yourself. You are the embodiment of everything that is wrong with California. Go fuck yourself, leave, or I will ban you.
Alex, edit your comment, or we'll have to remove the bad language. We have to edit your comments and block you.
You are the reason I understand when people complain about EU fandom.
Yes, exactly. You are everything that the fucking EU haters complain about, personified.
Like when CBR makes an article. Oh, welcome back. Yeah, when CBR writes an article about EU fans, they write about you.
Alex may be the worst person to ever exist in the history of the world.
I agree.
And that's counting Lance.
Wow.
Well, you know, you have to count person. Like, do you consider Magneto Alex a person? That would be the next
question. Not really.
Yeah, well, a cat.
No, true. Not even that. Like, he's from California. Like, what is beneath, like,
hey, cockroaches? Do you think I should take someone seriously who looks like this Magneto? Or like this, or this, or anything else? Or this. Like, is that somebody I would consider taking seriously about Star Wars? That's fair. I'm a minority. Yeah, you're a fucking fake Mexican. That's what you are.
No, no, what? That profile picture from Unbokiller was a mistake.
It's a great. Can you pull it up again?
No, because it's cursed.
I have better photos.
My face mixed with Karen Travis' disgusting face.
We have Kylo Ben Shapiro. Great.
You have better photos of Karen Travis? Why does that doesn't surprise me?
Yeah.
What kind of photos does he keep on his phone?
He had a poster of her growing up, probably. Yeah, I'm sure you're going to go to VC now and Magneto's going to join and you're going to argue. It's going to be good. Magneto, can you please join VC like in...
No.
In like 5 minutes.
Please do.
Please, come on, Magneto. No,
we're going to go into voice chat in half an hour to watch a movie.
Yeah, it's going to take like an hour.
And I don't want Alex to be there watching that movie because he's just going to talk random shit. See what I saw that?
Wait, what did you see?
The Matt Wilkins profile picture.
Yeah.
Oh, is that? Oh, did I switch accidentally?
Yeah.
Hey, Magneto, I have one question for you. Yeah, that one. That's the only question I have for you.
You should join. You absolutely join.
It's literally physically impossible that Noah hates you more. There's no space in his brain for more hatred of you. I've done this for 2 years. Yeah, well, there you go.
It may happen when I watch his Darkness release.
Can you make Sivan big, please? Like,
oh. This
that
is like
picture is awesome.
I wish Alex would get like his like arc, like the other Alex did, like a couple days ago when we showed him himself. From 2 years ago. That was awesome.
Mm-hmm. You think Magneto Alex will ever have his Fabe arc? He just becomes the most rabid hater.
I hope so, but I doubt it. He's not smart enough for that.
That's true.
Oh, Alex, what do you think of Matt Wilkins' genius timeline? That Young Jedi Knights is after the Corellian trilogy and before Hand of Thrawn in 19 ABY. And then Junior Jedi Knights is after book four of Young Jedi Knights.
That makes your fanfiction even more shit than it already is.
It's probably Timothy Zahn's fault, as we know.
Everything is.
See, Alex, at least that's something we can agree on. That is the dumbest timeline I've ever heard, because he doesn't care. He gave us two examples in the first two Young Jedi Knights books, where they say it has been over 20 years since A New Hope. I doubt that.
That has to be the rare instance where I'm going to defend Fabe. No, Fabe is a human. Like, you can't have integrity because that's a human concept.
Oh, but Alex, I guess if we go by Matt Wilkins' genius superior timeline, that means there is enough time for Jason to develop and change into the person he was at the start of New Jedi Order, obviously. Mm-hmm. Because then it's like 5 years instead of 6 months. Again, Matt Wilkins' genius timeline order. The expert. I'm glad that random people looking to get into the expanded universe watch his channel first. And that's where they get all the information from.
What's that? Where do you go? Was that like where you, I don't know, where you're trying out to get an acting gig on Breaking Bad or... You look
like it's an edit of he sent that in once. I think there's also himself as a woman on that picture.
Oh, you mean all his profile pictures in the Discord?
Mm. You think that Alex has the capacity to grow that much facial hair? Like, no. Genuinely?
No.
He could have shaved it off somebody else and glued it on his face. We don't know. Alex Salamanca. That's actually true. I don't believe you. I know.
Oh, that's female, Alex. Yeah. Gender swapped Alex.
I don't know. That looks so scuffed.
The funny thing is, that I didn't know it was his girlfriend initially.
Like, yeah, he always claims it is, but I don't really believe him.
Like, when I first met him, and his profile picture was, like, super zoomed in on her face, and I thought it was him, because they look alike.
I thought, yeah, like, the first 6 months of me being here was like, oh, I guess that's just him. And then he's,
yeah, exactly.
The first time when I heard he claims that it's his girlfriend, I'm like, oh, well, I guess.
I still don't believe that's true.
I can confirm it is true.
I don't believe you.
You look a bit too alike. That's the most base thing I think you've ever said. It's too white on Discord. Okay.
Poor blue pig.
that pig does really... That's genuinely weird, man.
Wait, do we have this as a rule? Because remember when... Sivad, you remember this for sure. Who was it? Who started it? Making the Photoshop female versions?
Like, I don't know, Cody Sparks, maybe?
Oh, yeah, I think it was. So I had to add that as a rule. You can't make gender-swapped images. Because they did that with me, and it was very, very bad.
I've seen those. They were amazing. Mm-hmm.
There's tanning beds. There must be whitening beds. Why must there be?
Oh, wait, I have to change rule 3. No disrespecting Ken Palpatine, in brackets, the character.
Yeah, it's not like people abided by that rule anyway.
Nope.
So, I think the female edits was Jason Solo. That might.
Oh, Oh, rule 20. People from California aren't human beings and therefore shall be ignored / ridiculed.
Mm-hmm.
Indeed.
Nice. No way.
Well, what's no way?
The female me edits. Like it was Jason Solo.
It might be.
Hmm. Then move out. Jesus.
Seriously, leave.
Move, you know what, move out, move to Germany. People will not recognize you as like Mexican heritage. They will think you're Turkish or something.
Yeah, that's going to make your life better, definitely.
Yeah, for sure.
But I'm right regardless. You didn't type that sentence correctly, so how should we believe you?
Wait. Okay, this is a late response. Liv, why have you seen the female Noah edits? Who showed you? Was it Alex? Was it the British-German Alex?
Probably. Oh my god.
I don't remember, actually.
Oh, that's Matt Mercury.
I think it was like right when I first started, like when I first joined. Somebody, I forget who though, sent all of the like cursed Noah pictures.
That's yep.
Might be.
Can you find? Can you send me?
Jeez. Just deny the Armenian genocide. Yeah, that's really easy. You'll do.
Wait, what?
The blue pig is trying to instruct Magnino on how to become a Turkish person.
Why is everything Alex's fault, Pico?
Which Alex?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh my god, where did you find that?
That's from your Into the Spider-Verse picture.
That's not my picture. That is a picture someone made. Wait, comparison. It's not that drastically different.
Wait, I found one.
Hmm.
But that picture is from when they edited your face on Andrew Garfield on the No Way Home poster.
Yeah, I remember.
And I found the picture because you uploaded it on your channel.
Oh, yeah, right, I did.
I found the one with female Noah and Denning.
Okay, send it in.
Where do you want me to send it?
Just Discord, wherever.
I'll send it now to mine.
Okay. It is always your fault. It's your personality.
It has the piss couch there with Dylan.
Oh god, there it is. Yeah, I think Cody Sparks made that one.
Jade, I look like an alien.
Oh, I found it.
You're...
I found it. Okay, wait. I found all of the edits that we dumped. Hold on.
All of them.
It was Magneto Alex who sent them to me.
You? Alex? No.
You do look like an alien, Magneto, but in my picture, you seem halfway to becoming German. Like, you just have to, you know, get it to... Yeah, he is. Yes. He has recognized that even as...
Wait, what is this? Okay. Oh, okay, I see it.
Darkness, I'm saying ready. Oh, Jesus, that is creamy sheath with Magneto. This full beard Magneto. Ew. It has full beard Noah. That's
That's cursed.
That could look cool. Can you try until
no.
you until you no. come to Frankfurt? Can you try to get that? That would
no.
sort of be nice.
No. Never. No.
Unforgivable love. Yeah, Magnino, you have so many pictures with yourself and Creamy Sheaf. They are a bit sus.
Like, someone leave.
The woman.
Oh.
Predator. All yes, right. Karen tries as the predator. Oh, that's a meme where Ken Palpatine still was in there. Yeah. That's an old one.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's end it here. Finish the game. We finished talking about the timeline problems. And we have to watch John Carpenter's The Thing in like 15 minutes.
Mm-hmm. No, you're just...
This one is perfect.
Is that there Dylan on the guy from Temple of Doom?
That's Josh.
Oh, it's Josh. Oh, God.
Oh, is this old... Wait, is this old Magnino?
Yes.
Yep.
He looks like a chipmunk.
He looks like a child molester, which I guess is accurate.
Yes.
But full Indian Josh is still my favorite here.
Wait. Blue Pig said everything is Alex's fault, and then he said Magnino is the leak, and then he said it's actually Liv. Jesus. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, I remember the finger that he had. Oh Jesus, yeah, then Sivet's picture that was also cursed.
Noah doesn't look like a creepy uncle.
What picture of me?
None of them. You don't look like a creepy uncle.
I think that one's still an OG now.
Are we going to end it all soon?
You can do that whenever you want. Suicide is always an option.
Yeah, I was about to say, like, you can end it all. We would.
Well, I meant the stream.
We would miss you for, like, a day, probably.
Shush, I would miss him for longer than that.
You know what's scary about that picture of me with Denning? Me as a female with Denning? That looks scarily close to my sister. I'm kind of terrified.
Imagine you as a woman. That is terrifying.
Wait, Noah, can you send a picture to like Jason and make him edit her into a man?
As a comparison?
Yeah, and see how similar it is to you.
Sure.
That's a great idea.
Jesus. Okay, we ended here. We're going to watch The Thing in 15 minutes on Discord, I would say.
So 45 minutes. Gotcha.
Yeah, definitely. Sure, exactly.
Bye-bye.
All right. Bye.